Hello?
Hello?
Yes, okay, it's working.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah. How, Are we going to speak English or speak in Chinese,
我们的一向来不是阿吉巴郎的。
没有,上次我们的 first episode 景涛就是全部 Chinese 嘛。
True 啦。
Yeah.
Half-half 啦, half 啦。
How to half-half?
有参参的吗?
Got me?
有参到的。
Yeah, how come my setting a bit funny, I can hear myself, right?
Shouldn't you be able to hear yourself?
Yeah, don't know, but right, shouldn't be.
如果你把你的 audio route 去你的 mic 那边的话, 你不是听得到你自己讲话咯?
Yeah, by right.
By right, right?
Yeah. Cause I changed the mic,
Oh, 你用另外一个啦?
我用另外一个 mic.
可能有 delay
我之前 like, 有 delay 咩?
不懂 as in maybe for on your side
应该不会
yeah lor by right shouldn't 嘛
那
你讲你听得到自己
我听得到自己 in the sense that I can hear clearly what I'm saying 之前那个不可以 yeah cause the stupid mic stand 我老 stain my tabletop 咧, cannot stand it
什么会 stain 啊
因为我以前用那个 mic stand 哦, 是那种你懂, 它的 base 哦, 是一个 heavy 的 metal 黑色的圆圆的 metal base 来的 then I don't know
how
why
the metal stain?
I don't know I think it's the rubber lining that is underneath the base that stain 我的 tabletop
what amazing
yeah lor ridiculous walao luckily I put the thing on my tabletop 的那个 mat 的 我有一个 protector 我放在上面 then 我整个 protector 坏掉 then 我今天去买 我去IKEA买 哇老 8块钱 a piece of plastic 8块钱 ridiculous
哈
没别人 then anyway until I find another mic stand I cannot use that mic so whatever lah this one also can
yep
听得到对不对? 蛮 clear 的对不对?
Clear.
Okay, that's good. So, episode 2. Finally.
Yep.
After 2 months, right? Almost 2 months already, leh.
Why got so long?
God, we recorded in late September, leh. Now, November ending already, no?
Wow.
Yeah, lah. Cause, last month, we didn't record.
Yeah, lah. And, like, 本来讲要 record, you may record.
Yeah, lah. Then you fell sick, then you got exam. Then I got work.
Yeah lor.
Yeah lah, 不便啊. What to do?
Never mind. Like, 以后有空了就可以再来多一点.
对咯。 We, at most we record more in December lor.
Yeah lor.
How What are we going to talk about today?
Yeah, I know nuts about the that one leh.
What? The Nexus
Yeah, 我还没有去读哦,我都不懂有什么这种有。 Like, 不错的.
Then let's not talk about the Nexus, or it doesn't really matter, actually.
Okay.
The Nexus is, 今年有两只, okay? So there's the Nexus 6P and the Nexus 5X. Uh-huh. And the Nexus 6P 是华为做的.
Huh?
So, and the Nexus 5X 是LG做的.
LG sounds better.
Yeah. Then the problem here is that the 6P is the premium one. Then the 5X is the...
反而华为做的是 premium 的
Yes, correct 华为的 so-called premium Because What's so premium about it? Actually, I also don't know 就是它是 It's metal Okay Then 它有那个 chamfer edges Like the Apple phones Then
5X is like plastic
Yeah, 5X is completely plastic Then The 6P has 你懂了 那个 2500 Pixel time Don't know how many pixel 啦
2K 啦
Yeah lah 2K More than 2K lah Slightly more than 2K
2.5K
That one Better than The 1080p la. The 5X is 1080p Then the 6P is A better screen lor But 那个 screen 跟去年的 Nexus 6 是一样 spec So actually not much difference But the problem here Is that 它的价钱多少你懂吗 It's selling for $949 for the 64GB one in Singapore right? And then the 128GB one goes above $1,000 So the problem is You know, in the past, oh, Nexus, oh, people buy the Nexus because it's cheap, right?
Mm-hmm.
以前的 Nexus phone, oh, Google 都有, what you call it? Subsidized. Which is why you get like, the Nexus 5 for like 349 USD or something like that, very cheap. And then the specs then, huh, 是 top notch 的咧, 就是, at that particular point of time, huh, the fastest Snapdragon chip, they always use the fastest Snapdragon chip in the Nexus in the past.
Uh-huh.
The camera usually lousy lah, but that's a common Android thing mah. Android people don't know much about cameras, right? So, they always have lousy cameras, but the spec always top notch one leh.
Huh.
And the price is always cheap. Which is why in the first place there are people who want to buy Nexus because it's cheap. It's a good deal. Now for some reason Google since when? Since last year I think. Since the Nexus 6 they decided to stop subsidizing any Nexus phones. That's why they are being sold at full price. Which is why your 6P is like 800多块 lah, 900多块. Mm-hmm. And then your 5X is actually a very very low spec phone, oh. Yeah, then 就是这样 lor. Then this year but for some reason this year 那个 6P 很多人要买. So convergent 你懂 convergent systems 吗?
Convergent?
那个卖 PC parts 的, I think they take in ASUS or something, right? 是不是 啊? 还是 Banlion, I can't remember. But convergence.
Oh, you mean the computer parts lah.
Convergence systems.
Well, they suddenly took in more than Banlion leh.
Yeah.
I keep seeing their name
appearing. Correct.
So
they took in the Nexus 6P, and then there's a pre-order, and then the pre-order 炒到很大.
Huh? But why are they selling phones suddenly?
I don't know. Anything that makes money, I guess.
True lah.
But anyway,
but they're authorized to do that, man.
They're authorized, lah. Like, I mean, Huawei is asking them. Maybe Huawei is asking them, or they got some arrangement with Huawei to bring the phones in, And then the pre-order,
Huawei should bring themselves.
I don't know, Pre-order is Convergent 在卖的, then 在 Lazada 上面卖. And Lazada got a lot of problems.
Lazada is like trash,
Yeah, Lazada is trash,
Yeah.
Anyway, 它有两个 pre-order. 第一次, 哇，一下子就卖完了. But then, 第二次, they took in a lot more phones, but until now, actually, 还没有卖到. So,
that is like,
yeah, la. So eventually, no, la. Eventually, there's still a lot of people buying the phone. Like, it's probably the most popular Nexus phone in Singapore ever. But still not, probably not, like S6 这样多, probably.
Uh-huh.
Still, you know, the Samsung phones are still going to be more popular. Will you buy a Nexus?
If I have some spare cash.
If you have some spare cash. What will you use? Actually, I want to ask, what do people use their spare phones for?
I don't know. Leh. Yeah, I think,
yeah.
One day I key sell, then I will buy Nexus.
Why? Leh? Why must wait until Kisha then you buy Nexus?
都不会用到的, like seriously.
It's like that one, I mean, it's like, okay, I have on my table there's like 3 phones now, but I have no idea what to do with them other than use them as tablets. Like, you know, internet devices. Like, if I go to the toilet, I bring one kind of thing to surf.
That's why I say Kisha then buy.
Then in the past, I can bring a spare phone overseas. To serve as a secondary phone for my original SIM card.
True.
That works, until M1 came out with their data passport thing.
Then that eliminates the entire thing.
Correct. The data passport is so cheap. It's so cheap that unless you're going to Malaysia, right, there's no reason to swap a SIM card.
Yes.
Yeah, because even if you go to Japan, it's like $12 for the whole month to use your own, like, 3 gig data. 用不完的咯，12块才来。你去那边，你去那边买多一个 SIM 卡哈，it will cost you like 4,000 yen 哦。Yeah, I tried that the last trip, so it was really good. So I'm going to continue using the data passport.
Yep.
So there's no reason to bring a spare phone overseas anymore.
Certain countries la.
Certain countries la, yeah. Like, 它没有 data passport 的 countries, but most countries I want to go to, or most countries that are still safe to go to in today's context, 都有 data passport。
嗯、
I don't know about Europe, but nobody want to go to Europe now, basically.
True, lah.
No. After what happened.
Yeah, 给人家射死。
Yellow, yellow. You know, dangerous, no. It's not safe.
Apple.
Yeah, this is primarily an Apple podcast, right? Supposedly. Yep. So, what should we talk about Apple? I bought the Apple TV.
Has it arrived?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. For a long time already.
Huh.
它 launch 的那一天就到了。
Oh.
Yeah, I have it since day one. Then I set it up on day one. I play with it on day two. I play with it on day three. Until now, I haven't touched.
Huh? Then you play what?
There's nothing. There's nothing on the App Store.
The Apple TV, ma.
Yeah, yeah, it's Apple TV, yes, yeah. I know. But 它没有 apps 的嘞. There's not a lot of apps on the App Store now.
It's new.
It's new, la, it's new, but doesn't seem like anyone is interested in developing anything for it for now.
In the first place, like, 没有这样多人买的吗?
有嘞, actually, a lot of people I know all bought嘞. They bought it partly because it's really cheap, la. I mean, compared to other Apple devices,
yeah,
it's like $200+ a little bit. It's almost the same price as the Magic Trackpad 2. Oh.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
Why is the Magic Trackpad 2 so expensive?
Yeah, I have one on my table.
You strike lottery. Yeah.
No, la, don't have. La. That's why I'm in debt. La, okay. But, which is why in the first place, when they came out with the Magic Trackpad 2, Magic Keyboard, and the Magic Mouse 2, the mouse, I'm not interested. I never use the mouse, so I never buy.
Actually, mouse 2 is like not much different.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Only charge, yeah. Rechargeable battery only. Actually, yeah, no difference.
And then, the rechargeable port, huh, the location is...
at the bottom. It's so stupid, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever, lah. I mean, in the first place, huh, the mice, I don't like to use mouse anymore for computers. I mean, trackpads are much better for me, lah, personally, especially on the Mac. On Windows, maybe you can use mice, lah, but then on the Mac, you know, trackpad is better. Because you can do all the multi-gestures. The multi-touch gestures.
Multi-touch?
Yeah,
yeah. On the mouse,
like,
la.
You want to... 你要做 expose 这些东西,
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you have to use the trackpad. It's easier. It's much
of
easier.
Of course. And it's... Yeah, it makes more sense.
So anyway, 我本来就不要买一个 Magic Mouse 2的, so that was fine. But actually, I'm quite interested in the Magic Keyboard.But then, huh, exactly because the Magic Trackpad 2 costs so much, I have no money to buy the keyboard. And I don't think I'm going to buy the keyboard anytime soon.
Keyboard?
Yeah. The keyboard is quite nice, I finally managed to see one at the Epicenter at Wheelock Branch. They have one set of the new 5K Retina iMac, ma. So, the keyboard, huh, is...The one that came with the Retina iMac, which is the new one actually. 蛮好 type 的嘞. The travel is lesser, as in 你 press 的那个 distance 哦, the key, key travel is
shorter,
it's shorter, but then it feels nicer 嘞. Personally, 我不是很喜欢那种 clack 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 的 keyboard.
But all along, it has been very nice.
All along, yeah. The current one is actually very nice already. But then I think the new one can even be nicer. Personally, la, some people don't like the new one because the key travel like not enough.
I should go and try.
You should go and
Actually, I went to the Wheelock one, but I never tried. I didn't know it was the new one.
Yeah, yeah, you didn't know it's a new one. Only one set, like, only one of the iMacs have the new one.
I just went there not long ago.
Huh?
Yeah, the Wheelock one.
Then?
Yeah, I didn't try.
If you pass by, again, not important anyway.
Yeah, true.
Doesn't look like they'll sell a lot of them. Oh. Eventually, it's going to be... Most people are going to get them if they buy an iMac now. You know? They're not going to purposely go and buy the Magic Keyboard. Because it's not cheap, eh. How much is it, like, $100+?
If I'm not wrong, it's... yeah, it's the same price as the pencil.
Yeah, la, yeah, la. Huh? Is it? Yeah. 99, meh? 99, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. It's 99 USD, right?
Yeah. Same price as the pencil, right?
Crazy, eh, the price.
Speaking of the pencil, I haven't tried it out, leh. Cannot find anywhere.
You cannot find the pencil anywhere. Don't bother.
And no one is like buying. I'm waiting for someone to buy.
Buy what? The pencil? But nobody
the
has the pencil.
The entire iPad Pro thing.
iPad Pro, okay, you can try the iPad Pro everywhere. It's
yeah,
like
I tried
everywhere.
I went to like iStudio and disturbed them.
And then?
And then like play around with their things and then like...
How you find the iPad Pro?
Decent, but like... 我觉得, it takes some time for you to get used to it.
To get used to what? The size or...
The size and the layout.
The layout is the same, right? What's difference?
It's
the difference?
Weirder, it just look weird.
Because the home screen, the icon 很 wide, right? 很,
yeah,
the space.
It's like weird.
Yeah, because I don't think they did anything to the home screen. That's the problem. They
just
only increased the resolution.
Apart, right?
Yeah, exactly. So, hopefully, you know, maybe in the next version, they will add more icons or they do something else to the home screen. But for now, the home screen is weird. Yes, that's quite true.
I think with the next update, they will do it.
Next update is 9.2. Don't know, maybe iOS 10 or probably.
Yeah, I think 10.
Probably
I think it takes a major update
still to
long,
like,
do something.
That means we are looking at another 11 months or 10 months.
Probably. But as of now, it's, I think, still usable.
Of course it's usable. Yeah, of course
it's
usable.
Very nice.
The only problem I see with it is the price.
Yes.
Very scary, leh. Walao. You can pay like... Okay, in the first place, they don't have a 64 gig, so you got 32 Wi-Fi.
Your dilemma,
Yeah. The 32 gig Wi-Fi and then the 128 Wi-Fi. And the difference between 32 and 128 is $260, leh.
Yes.
Siao, leh. How are you going to justify paying like $1,500 for iPad? Has anyone paid $1,500 for iPad before?
Probably not. How would you have paid $1,500? Get talk lor, 去新店去买啦, 可能.
But that's different. That's like, you know, if you run into the Joe Chew or something like that,
yeah,
maybe they'll chop you. But that's different. That's totally different. The issue here is, firstly, is you look at it, it looks like iPad. Okay, it's a bigger iPad, yes, but do you think you will pay $1,500 for an iPad? Since you won't be paying $1,200 for the 32 gig. And, because if I buy a Air 2 or if I buy a Mini 4, right, mm-hmm. I can just jolly well stop at the 64 gig. I can't do that for the iPad Pro. So if I get iPad Pro, it has to be the 128.
Precisely.
They are forcing you to buy the
128 thing.
1.5K, leh. Imagine how much profit is that, man. Like, whoa. Like, when the MacBook came out, right, I don't even...
It's the same price as a MacBook, right?
No, it's not the same price. The MacBook is about $1,788, so it's about $200-$300 difference.
Well, technically, if you add the pencil and the keyboard there,
I know, right? So, you see, the MacBook is like, oh my god, it's so nice, I'm going to buy it, but it's so expensive, so I have to think and think again, so I didn't buy.
Uh-huh.
Then the iPad Pro, like, it's just an iPad. Like, technically speaking, it's only bigger than an iPad Air 2. And then, is there a lot more things you can do with it? Not really, I mean, it's faster, It's faster than the so-called speakers are better, but it's actually louder only. It's not like the quality of the
because
sound
it
is
has,
better.
Like, two sides now.
Yeah. Because if you look at the teardown, right, actually, there's a lot of chamber, there's a lot of space in the iPad Pro to act as the sound chamber. So, the volume can actually multiply much better as compared to the Air 2.
No wonder. I heard the... I fix it. They did a tear down. Then they realize they like to tear the whatever thing down.
Yeah. Then
they realize that if you remove the speakers and then you can add more batteries.
You can but how heavy is the thing going
to
be?
Yeah, like...
Of course, you can add more battery. Yes, you can add more battery. The thing is already almost 800 grams. How much more battery do you want to add? So, that's the problem. If you add, yes, you can add more batteries, but if the whole thing is just battery, you're going to be so heavy that you won't want to hold it.
Desktop replacement?
Desktop replacement, yes, but like, you see, you buy that iPad, right? There's no kickstand, there's nothing for you to prop it up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so technically speaking, you can use it as a desktop replacement, yes, that's what they want you to do it, but the thing is so heavy. It makes no sense, really. Like, let's say, for example, you buy the keyboard case, right? you buy the keyboard case and then you add the current iPad Pro, mm-hmm. the weight is still okay, like still around like MacBook Air-ish weight. No?
Yes, about there.
If you put the whole damn thing full of battery, right, it's going to overshot the Air weight. Like. Then it makes no sense to be buying the iPad Pro anymore. If it doesn't make you more portable.
I think depends lah. I think 有些人会觉得好。
有些人 啊, like 有些人 like who? I mean, yes, my friend, right, my friend bought the 128 Wi-Fi cellular on day one, eh.
Wow.
他 one shot, 他警察就是, 那个 store 一开, 他就买了, 他不用想, 他讲, oh, I always find the air very small. So, this is the godsend product kind of thing.
But I think, like, people that will want a laptop replacement, but yet think that the Surface Pro is shitty, will go for it.
Surface Pro is shitty, but in the first place, let's say...
And actually, a lot of people will go for it.
You mean the iPad Pro?
Yes.
我不知道咧,
I think they will find a drawback, right? 就是它不是 run full OS.
Yeah, is that really a drawback? That's the thing. I mean, personally, 你问我的话, okay, you see the Surface Pro, what it's doing is essentially just using the Windows 10. He just putting a Windows 10 onto a tablet. But because it's running Windows 10 and it's running Intel Core i5, i7, right? The thing is not actually that light, no? It's quite heavy.
Yeah, it's heavy.
And
but
it's hot, it
I
runs hot also.
I think for people that need to bring like laptop everywhere, they will find it's a much better choice than the actual laptop.
Why? Like, why is it a better choice than actual laptop? If you ask me, right, I'd rather buy an Ultrabook if I want to run Windows.
But a lot of people will find that like, Ultrabook is like... meh.
Meh. Why? Like? It's light, ma. It's a Windows laptop. So essentially, huh, if you ask me, the Surface Pro is nothing more than a Windows laptop.
True, it is. It technically, it is.
Technically speaking, it is, right. The only difference is that you get a touchscreen, which in the first place, 那些 Ultrabook, 有一些也是 touchscreen的,
also, yeah.
也是有一些是 touchscreen的. And then you get a stylus, which technically speaking, 你可以买的吧, technically speaking. 你去哪里,
yeah.
Yeah, you know, if you buy an Ultrabook, 去哪里买都有, probably
去哪里买都有的,
对. Then, and then you have to pay more for the 那个, you know, the track, the keyboard thing, the keyboard cover thing. So, is it really that good? I mean, personally, I cannot tell. Eh. 你懂, 以前很久很久很久以前, before there's the iPad, there's this thing known as the Windows Tablet, right? And then there's a Microsoft Windows Tablet Edition. 你还记得吗?
Microsoft Windows Tablet.
你还记得很久很久以前?
Yeah, 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 yeah.
它的basically就是, 它就是一个 laptop, 只是它的 screen 是 touch screen 的, 它的 screen 有, 你可以用一个 pen 写的。
Yeah, it's like, what is that? It's like, yeah, it's like XP, right? Hey, no, it's worse than that.
Yeah, it's not, I mean,
it's like Windows 2000, but...
没有咧,
like,
XP也有.
With touchscreen interface, right? Yeah, yeah, oh, then they port over to XP, right?
Yeah, 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 Windows 7也是有嘛. Actually, until quite... recent huh, the product was still there like, it still survived like, until very very recently, but then huh, most people 没有买的. I see the people who buy right are people who say it's better for them if they want to handwrite the notes, okay,
no, but it's ridiculous, as in my friend right, he has a Surface Pro 3 or yeah, I think Surface Pro 3 and then I tried writing notes down using his like what's that called, OneNote. It's ridiculous, you can't really write properly.
为什么呢?
It's still different from using a paper,
of course. I mean the stylus is not, you know, it's not high resolution, it's a Wacom the stylus, right?
Yeah, it's like
it's a, not a Wacom tablet, you see,
it's a normal
对, 就是一个,
stylus thing. It doesn't really write properly,
it's not very high resolution.
Yes,
so it doesn't work like you can't use it for drawing stuff, you see. Like, if you're an artist, you can't really use it for drawing. Because it's not good enough. Those people need to buy a Wacom tablet to do it. So,
that beats the entire point already, right? Beat the entire purpose.
You know, I also don't know what's with Microsoft and their whole, you know, tablet with a pen thing. Actually, all along, huh, the Surface Pro, right, if you ask me, huh, it's just an extension of 他以前那个 Windows tablet. It's exactly the same thing, right? You have a touchscreen computer, and then you have a keyboard that you can use, or you can turn around, or you can keep it when you don't want to use it, and then you use a pen to write. There's no difference at all. The OS itself is still the desktop OS. It's still desktop Windows. There is no difference.
Yes.
So, Windows 8 was the only time they tried to make it more like, what you call it, tablet-y. 比较 tablet, 比较像 tablet 的 OS, 对不对? But they failed, what? Which is why they came out with Windows 10, which is exactly just like Windows 7. So,
yeah,
so
it makes sense, right?
Yeah. So for these people, right? Okay, in the first place, oh, the people who buy Surface Pro 3 or Surface Pro 4, right? If you ask me, according to my friend who works in Microsoft Singapore, most of the people who buy them are in the education sector and in the industrial,
corporate, right?
Like corporate,
yeah.
Correct? Long time ago, that Windows tablet thing, right? The same people are buying it.
Seriously?
Yeah, so the education sector and then the corporate sector.
还有谁会买?
你自己在家用的话, 你真的要买一个 Surface Pro 吗? Consumer 没有人买的, actually. 没有人买这种东西的,
yeah, true.
So, is it really that much better? If you ask me, right, Surface Pro is a bad tablet because it's too heavy. And then it doesn't run a tablet OS. And then it's a bad Windows PC. Why? Because the screen is so small, it's underpowered, the keyboard sucks.
It's underpowered, okay, as in like, I have tried and then I realize the keyboard is like so-so. It's like
你买那个, as in, you actually have to buy the type cover, right? The keyboard cover.
Yes, the keyboard cover
that
thing.
Costs,
but
like,
I think
多少钱了, right? 几百块,
for like Microsoft, right? They tell you you have to buy.
You have to buy. Technically speaking,
其实是半买半送的, 对,
半买半送,
就是你买他一定会送你一个的,
没有咧, 不会咧, I don't think so咧. It's not free one, the tab cover.
Usually la, like our local like seller, like New State or this, they will
bundle
you,
the
like,
thing,
Yeah, it's bundled one.
So it's bundled for a lower price or something, is it?
Slightly la, I think like for them to earn also. If not, they keep their keyboard, then no one will buy. Then they will just rot.
I also don't know. So,
yeah, and then the stylus is like, you won't ever use one. Like, even if you have a Surface, the stylus will just stay beside the
keyboard, right?
Yeah, the keyboard thing,
You know how much that costs, the stylus?
Expensive, leh.
$59. Leh.
Yeah.
Hey, crap, man.
And it runs on the, what, like, you know, it runs on a very special battery, 4A.
Huh? 你要放 battery 进去那个?
You need a battery for it to work.
Serious?
You know?
Why?
Yes.
It's
and the
not
battery
even,
is like some weird battery.
It's not even some high class, what you call it? It's not even some high quality stylus.
Yes. It's very weird. I never seen the battery before, until I like see the stylus. I'm like, huh? Besides AAA, there's a smaller one called 4A. Yeah, and then the screen, like, yeah, because of the size, right, 13-inch, and then they try to squeeze every single sheet in, it turns so small, everything becomes very small, and then what else, oh, the battery life, because it runs a full OS, plus, like, I something, like, depends, like, you want 3 or 5, or it dies within, like, 多少?
两个钟头，三个钟头，有这么快吗？你是讲Surface Pro 的 battery life
啊？嗯，他不是讲有
9 hours of video
咯？你听他放屁，真的咩？真的。哎，你懂哦，他的
power supply 哦，不是 USB 的嘞？不是，他
copy MagSafe
的。对，他 copy MagSafe 的。So technically speaking， 你买一个 Surface Pro 哦，you still need to bring the fucking power，you still need to bring the power brick with you one 嘞。But
it's not very big 啦 ，but well。
Yeah, I mean, the whole point of using a tablet is that you use a USB charger that you use to charge your phone and everything else to charge your so-called computer. If not, right, what do you want to get a tablet as your portable machine?
No idea.
Right. I didn't realize that until recently also. It's like recently they were all talking about the Surface Book and then the Surface Pro 4, right? Then I went to find out then it's like, huh? That what do you call it? The power adapter is separate.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So technically speaking, if you ask me, the Surface Pro is just a lousier Windows laptop and costs a lot more. And then as a tablet itself, it's useless because 你不可以像 iPad 这样 hor, 随便这样 tap 它就开, then 你就可以用 hor, 很 touch friendly 的那个 apps. Most of the apps are not touch friendly. Eh? Most of the apps 你还是有那个 window 还是那个 cross, then 你要去 tap 那个 cross. Eh?
That's a very big issue with Windows. They cannot control the apps that people make.
It is stupid because 你看啊，因为 Windows 它有两种 apps, 它有 Metro apps, then 它有 normal desktop apps. Yeah. But for Windows, right, there are no decent Metro apps. They are all desktop apps. So if you are using a laptop, if you are using a tablet, you want to use a tablet with all the Windows and then all the cross and all the stuff. And then you need to use a mouse like that. You need to tap the small menus in order to, basically you're using your finger like a mouse pointer,
like a stylus,
like a mouse pointer, basically.
Yeah, yeah, like a mouse pointer.
So it makes no sense. I don't understand. Why is it like that? Why do you want a computer like that? Windows. Windows. In the first place. Anyone who want to buy Windows. Buys it because it's a cheap OS. It's a cheap computer. Windows computers are all cheap. So why do you want to pay so much money for a computer that is supposed to be cheap, but for some reason it's not as good as
it's being upsold?
You know, it's basically a computer that's lousier than a cheaper Windows computer. Less powerful, have a lot of issues.
Hipster lor, act hipster lor.
Hipster man?
I don't know. They think they're very hip.
Very hip man? I don't understand that.
Juk, look at me, it's a tablet, it has a keyboard.
What does that mean, man? I mean, you know, you see all the operating systems, ma, 不是, okay, so you have Microsoft one side, you got Apple another side, ma. And Microsoft, all along, Microsoft is doing, it's just that they keep insisting that 他们的 Windows, their Windows is so powerful that they can adapt it to everything, They can adapt Windows to what? They can adapt Windows to ATMs. They can adapt Windows to 那种 glass display, 那种 video displays.
Well, technically, our local ATM are running
Windows, basically.
Windows NT.
Yeah, I know. So, they basically adapt their desktop OS Windows into a laptop OS. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. It's different. Unless you start building something different. You know, the problem with Windows, the problem with Microsoft is that they are stupid. They got one OS, which, if they built up, will be a very powerful tablet OS. Windows Phone. Windows Phone. They got Windows Phone, right? Windows Phone, the OS, and Windows 不同的 leh.
Windows, what? Oh, yeah, yeah. Windows Phone is different.
Yeah, Windows Phone is different, right? Windows Phone is, it's not Windows, Windows Phone is built from the ground up,
It's another...
It's
totally
another
different
thing. It's a totally operating a new operating system. Yes.
And frankly speaking, Windows Phone, that OS, it's like one of the better OS that actually Microsoft has made.
Yeah.
But it died. It just died.
Yeah, because it's not popular, you see.
Of course, they choose to put it with Nokia. Come on, Nokia.
Yeah, they put it with Nokia, then the issue is they still want to license the OS. And then you see, when you got Android that's free, right? Why the hell would any other phone manufacturers license your Windows Phone OS? So yes, they can. Their solution to do that is that they make their own phones, but then one manufacturer, and then with the whole marketing thing, right? And then the whole Nokia thing. Nokia is on the way down, ma. Then someone go and buy Nokia. Then after they buy Nokia, right? They never really put out a lot of phones also. So, you see, nobody is going to notice them. Eventually, Windows Phone just died, sort of. They're still around, but nobody I know has a Windows Phone. But the OS inside Windows Phone is way better than, Windows.
Yes. Actually, 我觉得, they should, Why not they just like, you know, kill off like Windows as in that you separate the project between Windows,
mm-hmm.
and then develop further Windows Phone OS as a tablet. OS.
That's exactly what Apple is doing. The issue here is that 没有 developer 要做他们的 Metro apps.
True.
Yeah. So the only fallback they have is to use 他的 Windows desktop, the apps to put onto their tablet. If only then would they have enough apps.
That's true lah. Mm. Because in the first place, the entire architecture of the Windows, it allows people to play with every file in the system.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So 每个人 just 去 download 就可以了嘛，做 app
有个屁用。对，它就是 file system. Then so far Windows 的 see if you're a Windows developer right, you make a desktop.
You don't make money out of it.
You make more money than if you do a Metro app.
Yes.
因为没有人有 Windows Mobile. So as an extension of that, right, nobody will buy a tablet that's based off Windows Phone OS. So that's the issue. Then, it's a cycle. Your product, nobody buy. So there won't be any developers doing apps for your product. But then, if there's no apps for your product, nobody will buy your tablet.
Yeah. No, essentially, they need to start the cycle.
Yeah, they tried to start the cycle many times. Right? They have paid a lot of Apple developers money to ask them to develop their app. Correct. To develop Windows Phone versions of their popular app. Some of them actually did. But then eventually, people just gave up. Because eventually, even if you develop for Windows Phone, nobody buys them. Then the developer got to support
keep
the
updating,
app.
Yeah,
keep updating the app. And it makes no sense. So they don't want to do it. Then eventually you got Windows Phone OS 好像死掉这样咯, basically.
Yeah,
then, so you see, if Microsoft wants to sell tablets, the only OS they have to put on is Windows Desktop Windows. But it's exactly because they put Desktop Windows inside, right? They came out with a shitty tablet that is not as good as any other tablet. Then they came out with that same tablet is also a shitty Windows PC.
True.
So exactly that is exactly why I think the Surface Pro, the whole line, right, is bad. It's basically not good. It's the wrong idea basically. They have been pursuing this idea for a long, long time, like that, the desktop Windows is good enough for tablet and for desktop. But a tablet OS is a tablet OS. A desktop OS is a desktop OS.
Yes.
Yeah. So I don't think they will succeed. Eventually, you can, this is a fact. Some people will still buy. 肯定有人买的，因为 why? Because it's still a very light desktop.
It's still a replacement.
Yeah, it's still a very light Windows desktop. So some people will want that. Okay, but you are not going to get that. That won't be the majority of the people. Majority of people are still going to buy your Dell or you're going to buy your Lenovo. So these people, you know, they won't get critical mass. They won't sell enough for it to be the future of Windows.
Yes.
Yeah.
But it won't die, so it's like 半死不活了。对咯，就是
I mean, it,
which
it
is
will
essentially
go on,
now
lah. Yeah, it will go on just like the hobby, just like a hobby. Just like, you know, Google make Nexus phones. Nexus phones are never going to be mass market.
Yeah, true.
So same thing, it's just their hobby, it can never go anywhere, it will just be stuck there. And that's why I don't think the Surface Pro is as good as, say, iPad Pro.
True.
Like, if you're on the Mac side, right, 不是有分, iOS, Mac OS, OS 10,
Yes.
Okay. So, a lot of people say, Tim Cook should combine iOS and OS 10 together.
He should never do that.
To make a hybrid. The problem is, if you make such a thing, right, who is going to buy it?
Who is going to buy it?
Like, let's say for example, let's say mm-hmm. What you call it? Let's say for example, the iPad Pro 哦，不是现在这个 iPad Pro， the for in another universe 哦， the iPad Pro is a hybrid. That means it runs
okay.
OS 10.
It runs full OS. Okay.
It runs OS 10. So what's going to be? You see what is going? How should I phrase this? Would that be a good iPad? Would that be a good strategy?
Mm-hmm.
Do you think that's a good strategy? You know?
Mm.
Do you think that would be a good product? So
no.
You got this iPad, okay, that runs OS.
It'll be shitty.
Yeah, and then it's a touch screen, but then you got no keyboard. Even though the OS itself is keyboard based, as what you call it? It relies on the keyboard and the trackpad. Correct.
Yes.
So.
It defeats the entire purpose of having iOS in the first place.
And somehow, imagine if it has to run OS 10, right? That means it has to run on, let's say if they can run on ARM, okay, fine, it can run on ARM. But then OS 10 is a more way more complex OS, and you would need, basically it will take more energy to run it.
Yes.
So your iPad Pro will be thicker and then heavier because you need more batteries. And then you will have to sell the iPad Pro with the keyboard.
Yes. It defeats the entire purpose.
Right now the iPad Pro, right, you don't have to buy with the keyboard. Technically,
you can still use.
Yeah, you can still use, exactly. Because just like any other iPads, right, you just have to attach if you want to use a keyboard, you can use a Bluetooth keyboard. You don't have to use their, you know, smart connector thing keyboard.
Yes.
Okay.
Which I feel is like 比较好 leh.
You mean what? The smart connector?
No, as in like just get the iPad Pro.
And
then just easily you can just use like your key to go and
correct. Exactly. Yeah. Which is why you can buy the iPad Pro now. You don't want to buy a keyboard. It's up to you. You can use the on-screen keyboard if you like. I mean, you know, that's the whole point of the iPad. It's a tablet. You shouldn't be requiring like external accessories to use. Like, let's say if you're buying the iPad Pro just to consume media, you don't want to do a lot of typing, there's no reason for you to buy a keyboard.
Yes.
Yes, it might be a pro, but doesn't mean that you have to do your work on it.
Yes.
If your work is like Tim Cook, all you have to do is like reply email, there's no reason why you want to buy a keyboard, right? And if you want to run an OS X machine, even if OS X somehow, someday become touchscreen enabled, right? You will still need a keyboard and a trackpad to be connected to the machine. So, in fact, the best machine for OS X is already on the market. It's the MacBook, the Retina MacBook. It's super slim, okay? And then it has a nice keyboard. Some people don't like the keyboard. It has a keyboard,
and
it has a trackpad. It's gold and it's space gray.
And it's gold, yeah.
So, the only problem with, maybe somebody would say is a problem, is that maybe the MacBook now is currently a bit slow, but you know, give it 1 or 2 years, it'll be fast enough. So you already got the optimum product for OS 10. Why would you want to put OS 10 in the iPad? You shouldn't do that. That's the point. The iPad is good. The iPad Pro is good because it runs iOS. Yes, iOS still got issues. But you must know iOS is completely, although the iOS is built from the roots of OS 10, but it's built from
totally
ground.
Separate.
Yeah, it's exactly, it's a new product that's built from the ground up. So it's better to add features to a new product than to adapt features on an old product to make it run on a tablet.
Yes.
So you see, OS 10 is a very old operating system. It has been in existence since the late 80s. Because before OS 10, right, it was Next Step.
Next Step.
Okay. So since the underpinnings, right? The underpinnings is exactly the same. Which means this OS is like 30 years old already. So it has all the problems that it has all the legacy crap of a 30-year-old operating system.
Yes.
Tag on to it. There is no way to undo most of this problem. Most of this legacy crap, which is why in the first place they will take it. It will run on a lot more power. it would need a lot more power to run and all stuff.
Yes.
It's much easier to tack on features onto a brand new OS than to adapt features on the old OS.
Yes.
Mm. Yeah, lo, that's what I think. La,
and personally. Essentially, Mac OS is tailored for MacBooks.
Yeah. I mean,
iOS is tailored for iOS devices.
Yeah, for touchscreens. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Then exactly, it's exactly right. OS
so, 10
is,
yeah.
OS 10 is made for to run on right now Intel processors.
That's so, why I don't know, some people key sell, they think that you have like hybrid or whatever.
No la, hybrids won't sell. The problem is everybody keep thinking Apple has to somehow, you know, compete with Microsoft. But Microsoft doesn't sell enough computers
to even fight Apple.
Yeah, to be even considered a competitor.
Yes, what they sell are softwares.
They sell Windows. Yes, they sell Windows. That's about it. They sell Surface Office. Pros, you know, all this stuff.
Yep.
You know, Apple sell more iPods today than Microsoft sells Surface Pros.
Of course.
It's that bad. Eh? So it's like, why give a damn about the Surface Pro? It's a bad product.
But people see it this way, ma. Mm. Yeah, lor.
But
just like how people see iPhone and Samsung.
The only problem is, if you ask me, people see it this way because a lot of these people are from Microsoft side. They use Windows products for their whole life, and they only got interested in Apple ever since the iPhone came out, and then Apple became popular. Long term, Apple people, I don't think anyone wants a hybrid device. You know? Do you know? In the past, there is a touchscreen Mac. That's not made by Apple.
Touch.
You ever think of ModBook?
很熟嘞.
有这个东西的嘞. In how many years ago? Probably about 7-8 years ago. Okay. There is this company that buys MacBooks, right? Like the MacBooks.
And then they mod it.
They mod it. They basically remove the keyboard, right?
Uh-huh.
And then they replace the screen with a touchscreen.
Remove the keyboard.
Mm.
Okay.
So you imagine you那个 plastic 白色的 MacBook 以前那种, okay, 你把那个 screen
PVC 的啦,
你把那个 keyboard 拆掉, okay, then 你放一个 touchscreen 的 screen 哦, then 你 seal it into 那个 body. Then you basically make OS X touchscreen enabled. So what you get 就是一个 MacBook 的 body with a touchscreen, the screen. Then you use a pen to select it. You use a pen to use it lah. 就是跟 basically 因为 OS X hor, by default 它就已经有 touch 的那个
capabilities.
It's just that it's not the same. You basically you are using the stylus that comes with the MacBook as a mouse. The MacBook, it is made with Apple's blessings, as in Apple acknowledged, allowed that to happen.
Yes.
But it wasn't popular. Nobody really wants it.
I think because at that point of time, not a lot of people were using MacBooks. Yeah,
that's one thing. Yes, possible. But even still, the whole point is it's the wrong form factor already. It's not that Apple cannot do it. I mean, the technology is already there. If Apple wants to make a touchscreen Mac, they can immediately start doing it. It's just that they think that it's not possible. It's not a good thing. There's no reason to make a touchscreen Mac. Like for example,
it doesn't make sense, right?
It doesn't make sense at all. Because you see, let's say you have a touchscreen Mac, right? But then what you are doing by touching a screen, when you touch the screen, right, you are basically just replacing the mouse pointer
with your hand.
But you already have a mouse on your computer. You already have a trackpad on your computer. So why do you want to touch the screen?
That's why.
If you have to touch the screen, it has to be in the first place. The screen has to be built for touch input, like OS X. Like, there are some suggestions, there are some ways, there are some things that you have to do you have to use your hand to achieve on iOS. Then yes, it's possible. It should be, you know, iOS. You should use your hand. You should use your hand to touch the screen. Exactly, because the screen, the UI, the user interface itself, is built for touching.
Yes.
You just keep saying yes, yes, yes this time around, right?
No. My God.
What do you think, leh?
I think, it's totally ridiculous to one day have a Mac that is touchscreen.
Why, like, why is it ridiculous, eh?
Because... the trackpad itself is really good enough for you to input whatever you want. And the controls is amazing. There's expose, there's scroll, there's three finger swipe left, three finger swipe right, all this. Have you ever tried using a trackpad on a Mac, on a Windows?
Yeah, the trackpad not very good.
You can die. You literally can die. What you want the computer to do, it doesn't do it.
Yeah. Partly because the hardware itself is bad, I think.
Yes, it's, plus the software also, I think.
There's no reason for them, you know, to... there's no reason why Windows cannot get... You know, Windows machine cannot have good trackpads. I mean, it's probably the same hardware anyway. As in, if they want to get better hardware, they can put better hardware in.
It's the software then.
It's the software that's bad. I mean, but, you know, if they want, they can get better people to write better software for their trackpads.
They don't give a shit.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah. I think they really don't give a shit.
I guess so. I mean, all the Windows people who listen to this will be just like, these guys are crazy. But we all know. I mean, personally, there's no Windows computer so far that I use that has a trackpad that's as good as any of the Macs.
Yes.
So, you know, if you use a trackpad a lot, you know, you will hate using the trackpad on a Windows machine.
Yes,
I don't see literally anyone on Windows using the trackpad exclusively, unless they're really, really good. Most people would like to use a use a mouse with their laptops, even if they are in the middle of a lecture or something.
As in, most will just bring a mouse.
Yeah, lor.
Because the trackpad is literally useless. I mean, like, a normal two-finger tap VS, like, you have to, like, scroll to the place and then physically click another button. And sometimes it doesn't really work.
Yeah, I know, right?
Yeah.
I cannot remember the last time I used a Windows machine for more than 10 minutes. It's pretty bad, I mean, I used to...
For certain things, yes,
I used to have... I still have a desktop Windows computer under my table. But it doesn't have a monitor attached to it. For how many years already? I think 3 years already.
Oh, speaking of which, my Windows machine died.
Huh? What?
Died.
Why?
It died. Suddenly, 3 days ago.
Huh? You have a Windows machine?
Yeah, the desktop that I built.
Serves you right.
You don't... Yeah, ni piao, huh? Like, seriously, one day, you know, it just suddenly pop up. I didn't know there's this notification in the first place.
What happened?
It just pop up a notification that says, like, what, your USB port has a power surge.
Oh.
And has short-circuited.
Oh, that's not good.
Yeah, like, please remove and reset in order for Windows to work properly. And then, like, 10 seconds later, it just died.
The motherboard burner.
Yeah, the motherboard died.
Why did it short-circuited?
Do
you identify which port?
Can't. Because it's like all soldered to the...
What do you have connected to your computer?
I have no idea. I can't turn it on now. It doesn't turn on.
I mean, as in when it burns, right? What do you have have connected?
A keyboard, a mouse, a joystick.
joystick.
Yeah, basically that's all. And the joystick is not even like being used.
I don't think anything I don't think any of that has the power to burn your port.
Yes, I think it's the motherboard.
Yeah, it means the motherboard is shit, huh? What brand is it? Asus. It's all Asus. Asus stuff always break down. They always
not bad.
They always have issues, right? No, man.
Well, it lasts me 5 years.
Mm-hmm. What? How come we are talking about Windows machines?
I have no idea.
Yeah, lo.
Then why like die lo?
So basically about the iPad Pro.
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to buy one?
If I strike lottery, I'm why, like eh? Bankrupt.
Speaking of which, you fix your phone?
Yep, it's done.
It's done, ah. No wonder you said you were at the shop today.
Yep. It's amazing, but like, it cost 220 in the end.
Why leh? How come? The guy chop you, ah?
No leh, he say like, your screen cracked, but your LCD also damaged. So if you want to replace both parts, it's like 220.
I think it's bullshit, ah.
Yeah, right, I know. But fuck it, lah. I already give it my phone.
Your screen is cracked. Your LCD also spoiled.
As in, like, the LCD has been damaged or, like, whatever, like, it's...
So, basically, the original price is for removing the screen only. But I thought the LCD...
It's fused, what?
It's fused, right? Hey, it's bullshit, lor, that guy.
算了.
Don't ever go to that place.
Yeah.
有点黑, leh.
Never mind, lah. I already passed in my phone, so, yeah.
Oh, but... You said the QCD only charge you 200 plus, ah?
270.
Hello, then $50 only leh.
Hello, yeah, 不要再讲了，算了。
Then 你就直接跟他讲不要了，不要修就可以了。反正我也懒得拿去
QCD 了。QCD takes like I think a week.
有没？你不是 QCD 不是你给他两百七十，他给你一个 refer 的。No
leh, they take in your phone nowadays.
真的啊?
And then they like physically separate it, change a new one, and then give it back to you. So yeah,
they can unfuse the display, man. I don't believe, oh, it's bullshit, oh.
I don't know.
Can you change the display unit with what do you mean? What do they mean? Say it's more. I don't believe it's true, oh. I think it's bullshit, oh. My God.
Yeah, never mind, lah.
Okay.
The reason I don't want to go to QCD is because the guy specifically told me that he will have to take in the phone for 3 to 5. Working days, you which also, is essentially a week.
It's also the same, right? You gave the phone to the other guy.
No, like instantly, on the same day, he passed it back to me.
Was it?
Yes, I specifically asked that he do that, and he's okay with it. That's why I went on with it.
Oh. But do you find that the repair was well done?
Yeah, not bad. As in, after the repair, if it's like some... like are being shot or whatever, right? They were somehow, I have no idea how they do it, but they can, like, I think they pry, when they pry the skin, the screen, they created a gap.
You mean for the Abing shop?
Yes.
That's because they pry it using some, using, you know, screwdrivers or something.
Yeah. Because I've seen people that went to like Abing shops and repaired their iPhone. When the new screen is on the phone, it pops out a bit slightly, but it's very noticeable. And then, 你看得到, a hole, there's a gap. Yeah, so it's like ridiculous.
You know, all the ASPs, right? All the Apple service providers, they have this machine that can...
They can suck the thing out.
Yeah, they can suck the screen out. Like. So, yeah. I mean, if the guy, what's his name? Mike,
yeah.
If his company has that machine, then I guess he can do the same thing.
Yeah. I don't know whether he has it or not. But he did a very good job.
How do you find the digitizer? Does it work like before? Is it as fast as before? Is it fake? Do you think it's original? Does it feel original?
It feels original.
Feels original.
Actually, yes. Mm. And when the phone came back to me, it looks as if
It's brand new. Really? Yeah.
I can say it. So the repair was very nicely done. The screen fused perfectly with the body bag without having the irritating gap. So I'm fine with that, lah.
Mm. So maybe it's just expensive lah, but they did a good job lah, which is good lah. So I can probably recommend other people lah, but I should probably warn them about the pricing.
Yes. If they don't mind the waiting of the QCD, then they should just go with QCD because it's an Apple endorsed part.
Yeah, of course. That's that thing also. But you know, huh, even if you go to ASPs, right, you get them to change your part, huh? The warranty doesn't become, it doesn't stay with Apple, no. It transfers to QCD, ne.
Yeah, because it's their part now.
Because they repair for you. Unless they repair for you as part of a covered Apple Care incident. If not, right?
Yeah.
It's no longer.
Or it's a recall.
Yeah. If not, right, your warranty is considered, your Apple warranty itself is considered void, but QCD gives you the same warranty as per what you have originally. Which means if you have 5 months left, QCD will give you 5 months of QCD warranty.
Mm-hmm.
Which is fine and all. I mean, considering that now you only have
two
ASPs. Yeah?
There's a Apple recall program for iPhone 6 camera, right? 6 and 6S.
6 Plus. 6 Plus.
6 and 6 Plus.
No, not 6. 6 Plus only.
Oh yeah, 6 Plus only, yeah. Which is my phone.
Yes. Why leh?
As in, what is the thing about?
Okay, basically, there's something wrong with the, you know, the stabilization in the 6 Plus is optical, right?
Yes.
There's something wrong with the part.
Uh-huh.
Which means when you take picture, right, it doesn't have to take picture. Once you turn the camera, it keeps shaking or something like that by itself.
Only affected phone will have that, right?
Only affected phones will have that. So if you go down, right, they open your camera app, it doesn't shake, they won't change for you also. Yeah. Actually, in fact, from what I know, right, very little people have that issue.
Yeah. Because actually, this phone, the serial number is covered under
It's covered. My mom's one also.
But it doesn't have the problem.
It doesn't have the problem at all. So nobody really bothers. I don't want to risk them opening the phone also.
Yes.
Since they have no issue. I mean, because they said they're going to change the part only, leh. That means they're going to open your phone, leh. Allow.
Just to take out the camera module.
Yeah, makes no sense.
Yeah.
It doesn't break, then just leave it. And yes. Those with problems, they already have the problem since many months ago. So, you know, if you don't have the problem now, then you don't have the problem. As simple as that. Don't get it fixed or something. Anyway, they won't fix it. They will just open your app and then they say nothing's wrong. And then, you know, they won't fix it for you anyway. Are we done? I think we are done. Right? Okay, lah. Just let this be. Lah.
Yeah. Let's record the ending and then you cut the middle. Just now I asked the question. Yes. So, today we spoke about Nexus.
What? We spoke about the Nexus phones.
And then briefly about the Apple TV.
About the Apple TV that I don't really... I still like it. I mean, the interface...
That you haven't really actually touched it.
I know, I touched it quite a while. But I mean, there's not really nothing much to do. And I don't play games. So, you know.
Yeah, true.
And then,
do you buy the one with the Siri?
All of them comes with the Siri.
Is it? I thought one has the...
No. That is not a hardware issue. It's a region thing. Basically, that means if your account is US, you have Siri. So if you are in Singapore, your account
then
doesn't
have
Siri.
Then you just have the normal input thing, right?
Correct. So it doesn't have Siri.
You just use the US account.
Yeah, I have a US account. Hello. I mean, I don't have a Singapore account.
It's not a big issue, right?
Yeah, I don't have a Singapore account. All my apps are US one.
Which is good. Because Singapore App Store is useless.
It's quite okay. Anyway, yeah, so then we talk about iPad Pro and then the Surface Pro and then we talk about Windows machines and then we talk about your broken phone that's not fixed.
Yes.
Yeah. That's it for now, I guess. So you can contact me. You can find me on the Twitters at RYUWORKS. My website is my website, my blog, my whatever is
at your website.
My website is at macryu.com, macryu.com.
Yep, macryu.
And you can find me on Facebook if you can. No, don't find me on Facebook. And yeah, so Daniel, where can everybody find you?
As of now, still not yet. You can find me on nowhere. Okay, but I'll probably create a Twitter account soon.
Hey, you should probably just start creating a, you know, like create the Twitter account right now, man. Okay, bye.
Is this already the start of the one?
You mean what? The podcast? Yeah, we start already, right? Then if not, what?
Okay.
You're recording already, eh?
Sorry, I haven't pressed record, eh.
Ah! Now that you tell me. Let's hope. Shit. Let's hope 我这边的 recording is quite good,
lor. Never mind, I start from now, in case. Okay.
Okay, lor. Then start from now, lor. Whatever.
Listen, I start the recording now.
Okay.